Welcome to the tutorial using the outline tools in PhotoModeler. The outline objects are used to trace shapes on planar surfaces and produce CAD-like entities with minimal work. This boat deck project has been set up and solved using letter sheet targets and plane surfaces. Here's one panel of the deck that we'll outline. Switch to Outline Line Mode and click to define this edge. You're prompted for which surface to draw on. In this case, select Surface 5. Click again to end the line. Do the same thing for these other lines. This time, holding the Shift key to indicate the same surface should be used. We'll connect these lines with fillets. Switch to Select Mode. Click to select one of the lines near the end we want to connect. Then hold Shift to select the second line near the end we want to connect. Enter the size of the fillet and press the Fillet button. Do these same steps for the next pair using the same fillet size, and then this pair. For this last fillet, we just select the outline and use the Fillet button to close it. We open a 3D view to see the resulting outline. Outlines are also visible on other project photos. An outline is made up of connected parts. When you first click, the whole outline is selected. A second click will select just the part of the outline under the cursor. For example, here we've selected just this line. Here we've selected just this fillet. When you select an outline, the points used to create it are displayed on photos. You can click and drag these points to edit the outline shape. Outlines and their parts, including fillets, are fully parametric. Outlines can be created using other part types. Here, we draw a spline. Right-click to finish drawing the spline. Then switch to Select Mode to add a fillet connecting it to these lines. This single outline consists of the spline we drew, two fillets, and two lines. Outlines can also include arcs, as we'll see later. The circle type has just one outline part as they are closed. Click three points around the edge of the circle to define its shape. To select a specific radius, select the circle, enter the size in the radius field, and press Set Radius. The circle's marks adjust to keep the center and match the new radius. The same steps can be used to set a specific radius for arcs and fillets. Switching to a 2D template digitization project will illustrate more outline capabilities. You can extend existing outlines by starting the first click on an existing point. You can also connect to existing outlines by finishing on an existing point. A faster way to draw connected line parts is the Polyline tool. Right-click to end draw, or you can use the Escape key to cancel any outline drawing. Switching back to the boat deck, we show that outlines can be drawn easily across photos. For example, we start drawing this line on photo 5 and finish it on photo 1. The line thickness setting controls the width of the outline display. An alternate method to draw across photos, which is useful when the second photo is not open, is to draw a short segment in one photo and reposition the end in the other photo. Individual parts of an outline can be deleted. Click once to select the outline, and then again to select the part. Pressing the Delete key removes this line, splitting the remaining parts into two separate outlines. Conversely, existing outlines can be connected by drawing between their ends. For example, we can add an arc starting at this point and ending on this one. The third point defines the radius of the arc. Arcs can have their radius set to specific value as well. This is now one connected outline. We've seen how the Fillet tool can be used to connect outlines by entering the known radius. Commonly used radii can be added to the library. The library radii values can be used for fillets, circles, and arcs. Sizes listed in the library can be selected using the dropdown. You can add the radius of an existing fillet, arc, or circle by selecting it and choosing the Match Selected option. Now using a glazing application for illustration. If you don't know the size of the fillet, the Interactive Fillet tool can be used. Select the two outlines, clicking near the ends to fill it, then use the Interactive Fillet tool. A fillet is created, and the mouse cursor jumps to that position. Moving the mouse adjusts the fillet size. When the fillet is the size you want, left-click to define the radius. We use these outlines as examples of how filleting affects the endpoints of parts. Selecting this outline shows where its current endpoint was drawn. If we add a fillet and then select the line, you can see the fillet has extended the line past the point it was drawn to. Dragging that point still impacts the angle of the line and recalculates the fillet, but the length is set based on the fillet. A cutback is the opposite of an extension. This can happen if the line is drawn past the fillet location or an overly large fillet size is used. The point is still drawn at the position it was marked, and dragging it still impacts the angle of the line, but the length of the line is determined by the fillet. There are situations where fillet calculations can fail, such as if the radius is too large, the items selected are too parallel or don't intersect, or if the outlines use different surfaces. If a fillet fails during creation, a message will be displayed and the fillet will be removed. However, if modifications to the project result in a fillet being unable to calculate, the fillet will remain but will draw with a dotted line connecting the endpoints of the filleted parts. The dotted line fillet can still be selected and edited, but will not be included in an export. This drag highlights the parametric nature of fillets. That is, as you adjust objects connected to fillets, they recalculate in real time. For example, as this point is repositioned, the fillets on both ends update, giving a clear picture of what the point adjustment will do to the outline. You can drag points to new positions in select mode or while in an outline mode. Normally, outlines display with no point symbols. Outline points will appear in different circumstances. An outline's points appear while it is being drawn. All of an outline's points appear when it is selected. The endpoints of all outlines appear when in an outline mode so that they can be connected to. Lastly, if an outline point is selected and dragged, only that point will appear. This line was drawn on photo 1 and can be seen here on photo 2. The plus-like symbol on photo 1 indicates the marks were created on this photo. The circle symbols on photo 2 show the projected location of the points. If we drag a circle mark on photo 2, the symbol changes to a plus to indicate this is the photo where the point is now marked, and the point symbol on photo 1 changes to a circle. If an outline is positioned correctly on one photo but not on another, the most common reason is the surface it is using does not match the real-world surface. Two other types of edits apply only to splines. Those are extend and insert. While these options are only available in spline mode, they can be used on line or spline outline parts. Adding a point to an existing two-point line converts it into a spline. In spline mode, right-click on the endpoint and choose Extend Outline Spline. Right-click on a line or spline and choose Insert Outline Point to add a new point at that location. Outline Editing Summary. Points can be dragged and deleted. Outline parts can be deleted. Outlines can be connected at endpoints. In spline mode, points can be added to middle of lines and splines. In spline mode, a spline or line can be extended. The outline table provides a spreadsheet view of all outlines and their parts. As with other views, when you click, the whole outline is selected. If you click a second time, just that part is selected. The Properties pane allows you to edit the settings of the selected item. If an outline is selected, you can change which surface plane it uses. Pressing the Ctrl-Z key will undo the surface property change. If a fillet is selected, you can adjust its radius. For example, this fillet created with the Interactive Fillet tool can be updated to a round number. The Measure pane shows information about the selected outline or part. All outline data can be exported in 2D or 3D. Outlines can be output in a wide variety of file formats. When exporting to 2D, the outlines can be flattened, such as to a top-down XY view, or flattened by surface planes. Outlines can be output as line segments, optionally as merged polylines, and as NURBS curves. Here are some exported outlines ready to be used in our CAD package. In summary, outlines are a top-level 3D object type that can be viewed in photos, 3D views, and tables. Outlines are created from one or more outline parts, lines, splines, arcs, fillets, circles. Outlines are drawn in 3D on plane surfaces. The 2D position marked on a photo is shown at the projected location on all photos. Central goals of outlining are C0 and C1 continuity of export with filleting, and to reduce the need for rework in CAD.